anyways, talking about this dam again.
What you see is you'll see when you got the equipment running, you got it all fired up, you'll see it pulsing in the sky, just like you would an earthquake up there in the distance. You're not actually seeing the earthquake, but you're seeing the pulsing. Every time it presses against the granite down in the ground, you know, it sends out a giant pulse, you know, or whatever body of rock material is pressing against it, it'll send out a giant pulse, and this is just magnificent how much energy is in these things. But anyways, it's invisible to your naked eyes, you know, when you're looking. When you got the equipment fired up, you can see that this actually exists out there. And in the case of this dam, it's something like this. It was pulsing up and down. That's kind of what you get the general idea of what it is. But then when you actually take a look closer at it, you can actually see that it's making the same formation as this here down in this here area. It makes the same as the water is. You know, and if you got back behind the dam on the other side of that dam on the east side and you looked up at the dam itself, you would notice that this area here would be the pressure area. And you would see it all. And if you get the equipment and you decrease the sensitivity on it, then it starts collapsing like this. You know, it starts coming down, and pretty soon you're looking at where the most pressure is. And the most pressure, of course, is right down here at the very bottom of the valley here at Canopolis, as it hits the bottom of the dam, which is really interesting how this stuff works. And then, let's see. So if you're looking for, if you're looking around, you know, and let's go back to how this works. So anyways, I discovered the dam was actually like a man-made fault just by looking for the other one, even though the other one was out there. So I just got about 10 miles away from this dam, you know, and then I could see that the earthquake still had its pressure out there, you know, silent earthquake. It's not an actual earthquake. It's not breaking, you know. It's just stretching back and forth like a rubber band, you know. That's what all these earthquakes do. They stretch back and forth like a rubber band, and pretty soon, you know, if it's just right, then it actually breaks. That's how it works. You know, so it's kind of like if you're over here, like, you know, let's say you're over there at WSU, there at the big fault there at WSU, you know, you'll probably never have a big earthquake over there, but it's a good little link area to show you about the western coast and like a Mexico City, you know. So if you want to study them there, you know, you'll have to be in that one little region around Wichita. So if you want to come out here and you want to do the other one, you'll have to be out here by Hayes and Russell, you know, Kansas. And then each one has its own link, you know. WSU, the Wichita region, has it down in Mexico, and then off the coast of California, Oregon, and then you just do that. So what you do is basically what happens is it's just basically like plumbing, probably. You know, you have your plumbing. You better cut it here a second.